what's wrong with the Piaggio again? The answer is, I don't know. It has the same kind of issue as it had the last time. So it doesn't really want to start up again. And I don't know, is it the spark plug the wire, or is it the spark plug the plug itself, or is it again the CDI stator? I have no idea. Last time I test this thing out. The problem was this thing that I can test the spark minus end, where what you connect to the ground, that fell off. So I don't know, did I get any proper readings? So now I need to test this again, so I can determine if it's the stator, CDI, or is it just the spark plug, the plug, or the wire. And if someone is asking how long has it been broken, the answer is 2 weeks, at least. 2 weeks, I rided this thing to the Volvox job, and there, from there, I got back to home, right around here around. I was coming, and I need to always turn around to get the scooter to here. So I come here, turn the thing around, and then it dies on me. I try to restart it, anything, but it just doesn't fire back up. It would fire up momentarily, but it just wouldn't stay around. I tried to adjust the idle screw and little this and that, and then I took off the spark plug and noticed that the spark has went away again. And I maybe need to test out the new spark plug. This thing. For this thing. And yeah, I got a new spark plug for it. So the issue is, once I have the spark is supposed to come into this CDI box. There's like a hole which through the wire comes, and through that hole there's supposed to be some spark. But if it doesn't spark, then that means CDI bad. Oh shit. So now the jumper pad is dead, and the battery is as well dead. But before that, I managed to do like one run, two runs to see where the spark is. So the spark at least comes to the CDI, but it doesn't, from the other end of the CDI, it doesn't light up the spark, the spark tester, or what you call it. I can see the arc, the spark itself. So I think what I'm gonna do is, if the one of the stores is open that sells the spark plug and the wire, this thing, the spark plug wire, and the spark plug itself. So this is supposed to go on here like this, and this other end is going to go on the CDI. So if I can get these two from somewhere, I think this issue will be resolved. epoxy time. I just had some epoxy and I glued this back together. Because when I was testing out the scooter's wiring system, like the stator and where's the spark, it didn't really hold itself together. So, some of my footage just got corrupted, like couple of two time lapses and couple of other like a montage videos where I was showing about the shifter. So the shifter knob is installed with glue, the epoxy, and it has been holding on really well for the past 48 hours, I suppose. Or, yeah, 48 hours it has been glued on. So, major success. Little update on the Peugeot. On the dashboard, the airbag light is still illuminated, but where I'm working at the Wallbox, they have like a code reader for the OBD2 port what's under there, so I hope they can remove that airbag light, because if they cannot remove the airbag light like they put in the computer, that and it will say to the Peugeot computer system that you light need to go away, then the problem lies right below, like under there. There's the airbag unit, and to it comes two exact same connectors from the dash. I don't know what those connectors are. I assume they are for the some sort of a seat system, because those connectors will end up in the seats, but I don't know really for what they are, because these seats with airbag? No, I think it's to these pre-adjusters that these will, in accident situation, will pull like inwards, that the belt will be tight on you, and I think that's for that, and I don't know if they are like coded differently, so if those connectors are like flipped and then you put the power on, it will put the airbag light on. And a shitty thing with airbag lights, once it comes on, you cannot remove it yourself, like you need the OBD2 code reader to remove that thing, light, just because maybe I have plugged those two cables there the other way around. Other than that, with the Peugeot, the blower what it blows the warm air from the engine bay, like in winter it's very useful warm air, so the blower motor that blows the air from the engine bay to the cabin, the blower motor has gone dead. So I could turn the blower motor on, but in about like a minute it would start acting up, and then after 2 minutes it would smell like electrical, like something electrical is melting a little bit. I think it's the electric motor that has just given up completely, so that is making the smell, or the wires, I don't know, I haven't looked into it, I just haven't turned on the blower.
Other than that, the Peugeot has been worked really well. I just need to take it to wash, even though it doesn't look too dirty, but the rims are getting from all the brake dust. They usually brake dust, so they're getting dirty. So I need to take it to a power wash. 1,000 times better. But many people just don't give a damn about cars, so in many situations, as I have been mechanic, I seen the rims being caked in brake dust. But people clean your brake rims from the brake dust. That's going to be the wrap for today's video. So thank you for watching and see you in the next one.